Oh, But they must come with him. When he was with Ram in Prabhu, Ram ordered so many things which were very, very thankful to him. When Dasarath Maharaj told that he should go to the forest for 12 years and Bharat will be the king of Ayodhya, Ram gladly accepted this. Lakshman was not in the show. He took his bow and arrow and told them, "Ram, you should give me order. I will kill all." And this lusty Dasarath also. I think that it is not appropriate to be a father. You are my brother and my elder brother. So you should tell me, order me. I will fight against them and I will kill Maharaj Dasarath, Bharat, and all of the whole army. And he took the bow and pushed the bow. But Ram was gone. First thing, if he was not my elder brother, then I have done this, but I am bound to obey. When he told, Ram told that Lakshman, take Sita. Forever I have left Sita, you should take with you Sita and give up in very deep forest. He wanted to question Ram, what follies has done Sita? Why you are doing so? You are going to obey the orders of very nasty persons, lusty persons, like a washerman, and you are not believing on the words of Maharaj Dasarath, Vasishtha, heir on the Agni, the fire goddess, and all the rishis like Narad and all. Wanted a question. What fault has done Sita? But he cannot say. He must avoid him because he is elder brother. So he accepted this, but very painful act for him. And then he took Sita. Not telling anything that I am taking you for giving him the forest. All we will return tomorrow after distributing cloths to Muni and Rishis, wives and ladies and their sisters. But when he went and crossed Ganges and went in the hut of Bhagavan, he began to weep loudly. Sita told him, "Why you are weeping?" He told that, "I should die before telling this. My heart is made of stone or iron. So I am not dying." Ram has left you forever. And he cannot return to Ayodhya as his wife. Then Sita had once felt flat and Lakshman in the same state when she was senseless, weeping. So he is telling himself, "Now I will come with Ram, I will come with Krishna, but not as a younger brother to obey. But I will order them, him, so I must come as a
elder
brother, I cannot bear this so painful thing. So he can, as a elder brother in Krishna pastime, and sometimes he rebuked Krishna, chastised, "Oh, you are doing wrong." But only to please Krishna. So again, he came when Krishna came in the shape of Gaurachandra, Shakyamandan Gaurachandra. He came before Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. About, I think, 10 years or like, he was elder than Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. He has never met with Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Satyanivai Pandit. Inquired by who? Went for pilgrimage with a very renowned Ains saint. And he went over whole India, almost all holy pilgrimages. When he was in South India, Pandarpur, there is a place named Pandarpur, he made it a saint. His name was Lakshmi Pati Tirtha, disciple in the line of Madhvacharya. Both sought each other and both became friends. Krishna, Krishna Te, embracing each other. After that, Nityananda Prabhu told that, "I want to take initiation from you." "I have not taken initiation. You are my guru. What mantra you will give to me?" He tested and told that, "Perhaps this mantra you want to give me." And that mantra was, "Kling Swa." Gopal mantra. No? Then he became so happy and said, "How can you do this? How can you do this?" Then Bhakti Nityananda Prabhu gave him darshan in the shape of Baldev Prabhu. And he climbed on the lotus feet of. He took initiation by that mantra and he became renowned sannyasi. And he then alone began to travel everywhere. When he came in Vrindavan, he was searching. "Oh, Kanai, where you are? There you are. Kanai, you know? Kanai, Kanai Hare Krishna. Where you are?" When he used to see deers running here and there, he began to run after deers. "Can you tell where Krishna is? Kanaiya, my younger brother?" When he used to see grazing cows, they used to take cows, this neck into the horn. Sometimes naked, quite naked, waiting so much. Sometimes running after cowherd boy, asking, "Where is Kanai?" Without Kanai, why you came? "I want to meet Kanai." And began to bitterly weep and roll down on the earth. He went to a temple and he was calling Karayu Karayu. The sun came and told that, oh, your Karayu is not here now. Now he is taken birth in the other shape, and now he is Sachinanda, and he is in Navadvi, Mayapur. If you want to meet, you can go there. So he, now, began to go to Navadvi by the side of young Narayan. He went to Prayag, and from there he, by the side of Ganges, he came at last in Navadvi. There in a very solitary place on the bank of Ganges, Nityananda Acharya. He was also a very good devotee. He went there. And he thought that I should not go to Nimai Pandi. He should come to me. It is Kanai Kanai. I will believe when he will come himself to me and meet me. Otherwise, I will not go. If he is Karai, then he knows everything. Past, future and Vartman, present. Also he is powerful. He is Sarvaka. Always. So he must know. Why should I go? Chaitanya Mahaprabhu sent Srinivas Acharya, his brothers, and all other so many devotees to such any Mahapurush. Mahapurush means?
Great personality.
Best personality, great person. Very good Vaishnava has come. Try to search him and bring to me. They search whole day here, there, in the bank of Ganges, in all devotees' houses. But they could not find. At last, in the evening, they returned. Oh, we have not seen any newcomers, Sadhu Sannyasi or Krishna. Oh, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu told, Nimai Pandit told, oh, they are not going. And then he took all, like Gadadhar Pandit and all other devotees, Sivas Pandit and all others. And he straight went on the house of Nityananda Acharya. And he entered the house and saw it. Very beautiful, long arms, golden, a golden mountain, very beautiful. Weeping and telling Krishna, Krishna, Kanai, Kanai. When Mahaprabhu saw, he at once become like dumb, and from there he was saying to him and he was saying to him. For a couple of minutes, the whole sight. And after that, Nityananda Prabhu and Gauchand at once run to each other and embraced so tightly and began to weep. He is telling Kanai and he is telling Balai. Kanai and Balai both were weeping bitterly. No sense at all where I am, what I am doing. And this fell flat on the earth. After some time, the devotees help them to come in the senses. And then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu took the earth of Nityananda Prabhu and he brought in his house. After this, Jagai, Madai and all other pastimes, Vyas Puja, after that, Sannyas Puja, after they went with Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Nityananda Prabhu, to Jagannath, in the midway, how Nityananda Prabhu broke his dunder. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu left all and went to Jagannath Puri and saw him, seeing, taking darshan of Jagannath. Oh, Prajananda, You are not a statue. You are yourself. Jasodananda, Vajendananda. And he made up. He at once suddenly tried to reach and meet Jagannathdev. But in the midst, how Bhattacharya came and how he came and how he took senseless Chaitanya Mahaprabhu to his home and how he tried to teach him Vedanta and what became of that. How he returned, he was the Puri Ratha Yatra and how he again came to Navadvi and Bengal and wanted used to preach our whole Bengal. Especially to those who were falling so much fall. Out of caste, very poor. And he began to preach. After that, how he married with Janma Devi and Goswami, Bhakivedanta Prabhu, the son of. How he took initiation from Janma Devi. So we will all hear in mind. I will pray to whom I will pray to speak something. Maharaj will speak first about Nityananda Prabhu. Yes, sir. Come here.
There are so many qualified persons. Yes, go there.
But Lomharshan first sitting of the same Vyasa, and he did not do pranam to him, not welcoming him. Baldev Prabhu thought he is not qualified to read Srimad Bhagavatam and to preach Bhagavatam. He knows me, not a very lower kind of etiquette. He thinks that I am worldly goes jati, so lower. And he thinks that I am worldly Brahmin, and I am so literate and I am so learned, I can tell Bhagavad, explain Bhagavad. But he told that you are not qualified. Be Bhagavad and then read Bhagavad. So he took his hand, and by his hands, and cut off his head, and he was dying. All the rest were wondering, and saying, oh, but they said, what happened? Then he told that, what one that I should make him again, give his life, then tell you the glories of with Baldev Prabhu. No, we don't want, but how you will hear Srimad Bhagavatam? He at once took the son of Lomharsan, Ugrasavana, of age 5 years only. Not very close and like so. He was like a very ignorant person who was looking like. But he took and he made him sat on the Vyasasana and look towards him. And he inspired everything, all Vedas, all Srimad Bhagavatam, all Purans, Upanishad and everything, Smriti, Sruti, everything, Mahabharata, Narayan and all. And he went at once and told some Stuti of Baldev Prabhu. And he began to explain all these things, wonderful things. So, you should not see that Baldev Prabhu or Nityananda Prabhu has not joined this school. And he was illiterate. But he God of course. His Gurudev, he killed in Krishna pastime Dhenupashu in the shape of an ass. Then that is ignorance. What ignorance? Those who don't honor Vaishnavas, devotees, and think themselves devotees, himself. They are all like Dhenupashu. If any Vaishnava coming in contact of association of any Vaishnava, he will be Vaishnava. And he will honor like Nityananda Prabhu has honored all devotees. Even those who are not devotees but they wanted to be devotees. He respected them. He brought in the shade of Krishna consciousness to all those who were neglected, all neglected. In India, the goldsmith, you know, and oil makers, better plate makers, all there are and Sudraja.
Sudhika.
At first, they had no right to reach Veda, Upanishad and Vedanta. They cannot read. Even. But Nityananda Prabhu told that, like Jagai Marai, they are most qualified to chant Harina and to have Krishna. And to whom he saw, he gave initiation like tell Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama. So all over in Bengal, all those were falling. Very unpicious cost of persons, Nityananda Prabhu embraced them and inspired them all. Today we are doing some mistakes. We are this ordinary, sincere and senior devotees, whole life they have served Swamiji, they have served Radha Krishna and Gaur Nityananda for whole life from the age. Anyhow, without reason, they are going to be neglected. Have also served so much, more than anyone of us. But I cannot go to take darshan anywhere. To whom I gave my samadhi of Swamiji in Vrindavan. Doors are closed. This is a very bad sign.
By this
we go to hell. That is sometimes, yeah, we should try to connect all these things. We should know that we are holding Mahaprabhu family. Those who have not taken any initiation but chanting Hare Krishna, they should be treated as the family of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And those who are senior, sincere and loving, serving for so many years, they should be more respected. Otherwise, Vaishnava opens. And Nityananda Prabhu like Ramchandra Khan, in his last pastimes, last days, went in Bengal in a place where very rich person, Ramchandra Khan, who wanted to
make
Haridas Thakur, went to the same place. That rich person did not honor any of the devotee of Nityananda Prabhu, and he told that, get out from here. You cannot host in night here. Nityananda Prabhu began to laugh so loudly. Oh, devotees are not honored here. Devotees are disrespected here. So, we should not be here. We are going, but I will see, I am seeing that tomorrow Mohammedans will come armed and they will cut all, they will slaughter cows here, they will prepare milk for place and the whole family will be cut down. And he left the place and the person not honoring Vaishnava devotees, next day they will slaughter it all. And the whole village they can burn. So we should always remember Nityananda Prabhu. Don't disrespect any Vaishnava. This is the teachings of Nityananda Prabhu. Always try to honor Vaishnavas. In what stage he is, according to Kanishtha, Madhyam, and Uttam, will have to know all these things. If you are not naive, then we are not devotees at all. For sure. Nowadays, they are not going to be so strong Vaishnava. In Vaishnava philosophy, and also doing according to, we should try to establish us in all these teachings. Otherwise, only showing like bottle and telling to others, it will not do. So, we should try to understand all the teachings of Nityananda Prabhu. Come with me in Puri. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was telling. Again meeting, I am meeting with same present Nandan. In separation mood I am burning for so many years and years. I wish I thought my present Nandan. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu became in the mood of Radhika and calling Krishna, Krishna. You are the same Prajnananda. And he began being in the mood of Radhika and he felt like dancing. Nityananda Prabhu was there but not touching. When Chaitanya Mahaprabhu in Shivasangam used to dance and when he used to felt like in the courtyard, Nityananda Prabhu used to
touch
in his arms. But here now, why not? Why not? He is thinking that now he is in the mood of Radhika and he is Radhika. So he must not touch. When he began to become insensitive, then he used to touch. Otherwise, not. Nowadays we don't know all these things and we do so many rasabhas. We keep Nityananda Prabhu with Radha and Krishna in the same altar. Jagannath in the same altar. You should know all these things in more superior advanced devotees. With them you see. Read Chaitanya Charitamrita in the association of Vaishnavas, Bhagavat. Ja Bhagavat Pada Vaishnava. And that is why Nityananda Prabhu ordered Jiva Goswami to go to Vrindavan and learn all the Shastra with Rupa and Sangha. He inspired him. And he became so learned that in the whole world at that time there was no any learned person like Yudhishthira. He defeated so many learned persons. How? Only by the mercy of Nityananda Prabhu. So, we should try to follow outwardly and inwardly Nityananda Prabhu. You know the song? Nitai Padakama. Oh, where she is? Where is Krishna? Nitai Padakama. And then you will have see some boys drama perhaps. Nitai Padakama. One time.
After that we will see a play by the children.
And then so many bhaktas are there, they will see.
Also,
In the fall, service, they became upset because they did not want to go home. They looked around at the beautiful forest and the bright shining moon. Krishna said,
I think you have come just to see the beautiful Vrindavan forest, but you must have seen enough by now. To go home, I'm sure you must have some babies which you left crying. Please go now and feed them. I know you love me very much, and you came when you heard my flute, but you should go now to your home and see your husband's mothers and children.
Finally, the gopi spoke.
Krishna, do not be so mean as to ask us to come again and again. We love you very much and promise you to become our husband.
The Lord smiled, and they slowly walked through the forest of Vrindavan together, singing and dancing. The gopis felt very proud that they had so much love and attention for their wonderful Krishna. After all, Krishna is the Supreme Personality of Godhead. But all of a sudden, he disappeared. He just wasn't there. And They did not want to go home, but they obeyed him and went back home. Krishna had made them really very happy.
Anyone has not told me like this. Well, person's door he used to go. And personally he used to tell, I want this only very givers. I don't want anything. But we are now deviating from this line of Nityananda. If you want Krishna prema, you will have to come in this line again. So Nityananda Prabhu is telling, I am responsible for this if you are not getting Krishna, Krishna. So each person sees. And in the last chapter, Rasanam Adharam Rasika Barasaha Vaishnavadhan. Rasanam Adharam Rasika Barasaha Vaishnavadhan. Rasa Patitatarana Smarata Paramanityananda Kanjo Pastija Tadam Vitvanta Che. Or you don't see that Nityananda Prabhu is only a bad person. He had not got his soul. You should know that he is Rasanam Adharam. He is Adhar. This platform of all Russians. Dasya as Bhade, Shak as Bhade, Basal as Bhade, and Madhavas in the shape of Anandamanjari, the younger brother, sister of Srimati Radhika. He became to test this, to become the platform of this Madhavas also. So don't think that Nityananda Prabhu only in well forms of the Krishna, in four Mandi Rasa, also in Madhavas. So Rasanama Bhavan, Rasika Bharat, he was so Rasi. He used to quarrel with Advaitacharya, you know, so many times, with light struggling, sometimes giving Mahaprasadam here and there. Advaitacharya told him, what you are doing? You are
destroying.
No Vedic culture in you. You are always in pure. Anyone does not know who is your father and mother and where is your abode. And you have come among us to take prasadam here. You have so much debt. You are all good. You have taken our
cost,
brands. This. Nityananda Prabhu at once began to laugh. Oh, oh, oh. And told her, oh, Advaitacharya, I have heard that he is so learned person and that I know that he is not a learned person. He does not know anything. He is telling that by taking Mahaprasad, anyone loses his Brahman hope and he becomes, he is doing offense in the Lord of speech of Mahaprasadam. He does not know the real power of Mahaprasadam. Mahaprasadam is himself Krishna. Mahaprasadam Govinde Namadarnam Svalpa Pandana Tantrajana Vishwasa Vainva Jayati. So they are calling. Sometimes they are calling him in the deep pond. In the Devanish Sarovar, getting water.
Yeah. जय श्री श्री गुरु गोविंद गंधर्व गगनधारी श्री श्री राम प्रभु बिहार की जय। प्रभु विष्णुपाद प्रेमचार्य स्वामी श्री भक्तिवेदांत वामन गोस्वामी महाराज की जय। जय विष्णुपाद अष्टोत्तर शतकोण भक्तिवेदांत नारायण गोस्वामी महाराज की जय। लीलावृष्टि विष्णुपाद श्री भक्तिवेदांत स्वामी महाराज की
there.
Okay. This is Chaturbhuj.
Chaturbhuj Prabhu.
Chaturbhuj, oh, 2 hours.
From Brisbane time.
2 hours. 2 hours Chaturbhuj.
4 hours.
Is it? From Swamiji?
No, Bhakivedanta.
Oh, your heart. You're so big devotee.
He's good.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
touch his feet there.
Yeah.
Prabhu, one announcement. Srila Gurudev is leaving tomorrow morning at the airport here at 8:35 a.m. and going on Garuda Airlines to Bali. If anyone wants to come before that, at least 1.5 hours or even 2 hours before that, he will be going to the airport. So your presence will be very much welcome.
Jaya Vrindavani, Jaya Vrindavani.